Hey everyone, I just got a couple quick little announcements here this afternoon. This is going to be really quick, but just wanted to mention a few things if I can remember everything that I got online for here. So it'll be good. This will be posted on my page and people can watch it throughout the day. Just a couple things that are on my heart, and I want to start with this, and I'll probably end with this. Just the beautiful line from Saint Faustina that I talked about at Divine Mercy Sunday. Jesus tells Saint Faustina this: "Tell aching mankind to snuggle close to my merciful heart, and I will fill it with peace. Tell all people, my daughter, that I am love and mercy itself. When a soul approaches me with trust, I fill it with such an abundance of graces that it cannot contain them within itself, but radiates them to other souls." And so, just again, a reminder that Christ is calling us to trust him and to snuggle. Isn't that a beautiful image that Jesus says, "Snuggle close to my merciful heart, and I will fill it with peace." All right, so just an encouragement to keep snuggling up close to the Lord and to experience that peace. Today's been a good day. Honest to goodness, I woke up this morning, I was drinking coffee and was thinking like I had an easy morning. And then all of a sudden I got a text from Ben here at the office, and he said, "Father, we have the radio show today." And because everything is so crazy, and I'm so dependent on my great secretary to keep my schedule because I'm a mess. I have no order in my life. I need a secretary to take care of my schedule. I didn't even have that on my calendar, and I totally screwed it up. And so it was like 10 minutes before the radio show, and we had mass to start the radio show. So I cruised over here, had mass. We had the radio show. It was a great show, and it just was a wild morning. But God's grace is always there. I could have freaked out and just said, "Oh no," and been paralyzed. But you trust the Lord. Okay, it was my human error. I made a mistake, but yet God still uses it and God still works with it, even though maybe I wasn't as prepared as I could be, and I should prepare more, you know. But God works in spite of that. It's a good reminder to us, like, not to freak out when things get thrown at us. Take a deep breath, move forward, and trust the Lord. And I really had to do that this morning for today's mass and the radio show. If you get a chance, if you go to the Real Presence Radio website, or their app, you can go back and listen to the show. We had a 2-hour show today, some really good interviews and some really cool things. So I really encourage you to maybe to jump on and listen and allow the Lord to speak to you through that. I think that's really important. The other thing I wanted to do is, and I'll mention this tonight at Mass, I was talking to Ben a little bit today, and starting next week, we're going to begin doing a Wednesday night kind of faith formation session. And what we're going to do is we're going to do a kind of like a book study on the following book. Okay. It's called Prayer for Beginners, and it's written by a guy named Peter Kreft or Kreeft. Okay. Peter, and then his last name is spelled Kreeft, and it's called Prayer for Beginners. It's a very small book with very short chapters that talks about prayer. And so I want to encourage you, if you can get it online and get it ordered, you might be able to get it on your Kindle. You might be able to listen to it on audio. We're going to start that study next Wednesday night at 7 p.m. And we're going to go through that whole book. Again, Prayer for Beginners by Peter Kreft. Kreeft. It's a short little book. It's got a gold kind of outline on the front of the book. And then it has the Sacred Heart of Jesus on the front of the book. Okay. Again, it's called Prayer for Beginners by Peter Kreeft, Kreeft. If you can find that, get it and maybe read the introduction, okay, and the first chapter. Try not to go any further. We'll take this bit by bit. They're really easy chapters and really short and simple. But then every Wednesday night, Ben and I are going to jump online, talk a little bit about what we read for the week, okay, and then take your questions. All right, you can ask questions on here, and we can have a little bit of a dialogue about each chapter of the book. It's a beautiful, simple book, but I think you'll all find it very helpful. So that's something we'll be starting next week, is a book study on the book Prayer for Beginners by Peter Kreeft, Kreeft. Okay. The other thing is Marquette Families. Friday night at 6:30, we are going to have a family fun night on Zoom. Okay, so I'm inviting all of our Marquette school families. You'll be getting an email today with an invitation, and this is for our teachers and our staff too. And we're gonna have a fun night. I've got a bunch of games that we'll be able to play. You play at your homes. There'll be competitions. And it's gonna be tons of fun. So look for that email, Marquette School Families, Friday night at 6:30. I'll be leading us in kind of a fun family night. We'll do some games and activities. I'll give you some updates on all the things going on here at Marquette School. I can answer some of your questions if you have any. And it'll be just an opportunity for all of our families to get together Friday night. Again, it'll be 6:30 to 7:30, a quick hour. And I think that'll be an enjoyable evening. So I just wanted to jump online and just give you those couple updates. See if you can get that book, Prayer for Beginners, either on your Kindle or on audio, or order it, have it mailed, shipped off to you, again, by Peter Kreeft, K-R-E-E-F-T. If you can't find it, let me know. I can send you a link. And we'll start a study next Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Marquette families, we're going to do a family faith night Friday night at 6:30. Make sure you get that on your calendar. And I think that's kind of it for now. We'll have Divine Mercy Chaplet at 3 today. We'll have Mass at 6 p.m. tonight. And just again, an encouragement to stay faithful and keep trusting in the Lord. And I remind you again of that beautiful, beautiful words of Jesus to St. Faustina. Jesus says, tell aching mankind. See how beautiful? Jesus knows our hearts. Tell aching mankind. He realizes that our hearts ache. So Jesus says, tell aching mankind to snuggle close to my merciful heart, and I will fill it with peace. Tell all my people that I am love and mercy itself. When a soul approaches me with trust, I fill it with grace, an abundance of graces that it cannot contain that within itself, but radiates them to other souls. Remember those beautiful words of Jesus. All right, that he is love and mercy itself. All right, and then he wants to fill you with that when you snuggle close to his heart. And then as he fills you with that, it'll overflow to others. All right, God bless you. If you're just jumping on, you can go back and look at kind of some of the announcements I had. But again, we'll see you at 3 o'clock for the Divine Mercy Chaplet and for 6 p.m. tonight for Mass. God bless you. Keep persevering. All right, stay focused. Stay faithful. All right, give somebody a call today. If you're struggling, call somebody. Okay, by golly, don't sit alone and isolate. Okay, sometimes I don't know who's struggling out there. All right, call a friend, call a family member, do something. Okay, reach out, call somebody. Maybe you call somebody. Let's keep encouraging and supporting each other. Okay, whoever's lighting off the fireworks with hearts and thumbs up, God bless you. Okay, have a great day. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.